A National Resistance Movement NRM Secretariat employee was captured in a viral video slapping a uniformed traffic police officer. Charles Makawa has been remanded to Luzira Prison. Yesterday, Mercy Timbitwire, 34, a public relations officer attached to the NRM Secretariat, appeared before Nakawa Court Chief Magistrate Elias Kakoza and denied charges of robbery, assault, reckless driving, and failure to comply with the police officer's directives and using a motor vehicle without third-party insurance. The prosecution alleges that Timbitwire, on October 18, 2024, at Makere University Business School along New Port Bell Road in Kampala, recklessly drove motor vehicle registration number UBM 4390 Toyota Land Cruiser while using a handheld mobile phone.
The particular offense that Timbitwire Mercy, on the 18th of October 2024, commercial program in Kawai Division, Kampala District. Assault is number 63061 PCD Makawa Charles.
She's also accused of refusing to comply with directives verbally given to her by a police officer on duty while driving the said vehicle. A state attorney from the Office of the Director of Public Prosecutions, Mariam Kruthum, informed the court that investigations on the matter are incomplete.
All our inquiries have just been prepared. I have instructions.
The court was packed with uniformed traffic officers, friends and relatives of the accused, and was adjourned to November 4th, 2024.
I'm even very happy for that man not killing. Wait, we are human beings, okay? We need some kind of respect.
National Unity Platform NUP Party President Robert Kyagulanyi, aka Bobi Wine, says that the bill that Democratic Party DP Member of Parliament Richard Lumo is fronting is aimed at distorting the constitution and keeping President Yoweri Museveni in power. He made the remarks yesterday, October 21st, while addressing the media at the new party head offices in Makerere Kavule. At its core, Lumo's bill aims to amend Section 8 of the Principal Act to allow opposition MPs in Parliament to elect the Leader of Opposition, LOP, rather than having the position determined solely by the largest opposition party.
Abafe, boba oyagala okuteleza ebyennonda zendo zekyandisokedde ddala kwe kukyusa engeri Electoral Commission akakiiko akakola ebyokulonda gye kalondebwa.
While commenting on the issues, Nyendo Mukungwe MP Matthias Mpuuga, Electoral Reforms, Kyagulanyi noted that what Mpuuga is fronting isn't something new before Ugandans, adding that he, Mpuuga, is just recycling what was already there. NUP Secretary General David Louis Rubongoya appealed to Ugandans to register with the National Identification and Registration Authority, NIRA. He also noted that the party is soon resuming its nationwide tour. The 2023 best farmers from Uganda have spent a week in the Netherlands exploring cutting-edge agricultural technologies that left them in awe. The tour, organized by Vision Group together with the Embassy of the Netherlands, KLM Airlines, DFCU Bank, and Cowardice Nutrition BV, included visits to top agricultural research institutes and farms, offering a glimpse into the innovations driving the Netherlands' position as a global leader in agriculture. They visited Hof Bovenin, a medium-sized dairy farm in Houwenin, With about 140 high milking cows with an average production of 39 liters per cow daily. The farmers witnessed the use of advanced technology for farm management, including robotic milking machines, positioning sensors, heat sensors to identify cows ready for insemination, and sensors that monitor whether a cow is standing, grazing, or sitting.
I just want to encourage us to keep improving on our breeds, to keep improving on our nutrition for the cows. Because if the cow is well fed and it is of a good breed, believe me, you'll have the best results.